You won't believe how many incredible new updates Canva just dropped on us. If you use Canva for your business or content, this update literally changes what's possible. There are 10 brand new powerful features you can use today to create stunning designs, edit videos super easily, and transform your business. I couldn't wait to tell you all about it because they're so incredible. I'm Natalia and I help creators like you turn content into freedom, income, and a brand you're proud of, so let's dive in. Remember when we got Sheets as a brand new doc type back in April and it was a big deal? Well, this time we have three new design types to help us create more. Let's start with forms. We can now add beautiful on-brand forms to any design and, more importantly, give the actual responses from them too. They work in any design type, so you drop them onto your website, add them to a presentation. There's so much you can do here. Just think of all the possibilities. We can get people on our email list. We can get feedback from a presentation when you share the slides out. Let people RSVP to an exclusive workshop. There's so much. Now, mind you, some of you may have already seen this or the other updates from this video in your account because the feature are always slowly rolled out to some users before and also after the keynote. But of course, you all need to know about this, so I'm including it all here. To add a form, open any design you like. This one is a presentation. And then go to the Elements tab to the side and you'll see forms under these categories right here. Now, there are some interface changes with these new updates too, so that's one of them. We have different templates that you can choose from. And when you then click on it, it gets added to your design. When you click edit, you'll see all the different types of questions that you can add to your form too. So you've got polls and checkboxes and things like that. And as with most things in Canva, the forms are editable, so you can keep them on brand, you can change the colors and the fonts. And then plus, you can also check all the responses that you've gathered right here, and you'll be able to add them to a sheet or download them as a CSV. If you think that's wild, wait for what's next. We have forms, so naturally we should also have emails. That's right, you can now build emails right inside Canva, and let me tell you, they're knocking it out of the park because Canva lets us do so much now. It's slowly becoming like a true one-stop shop for creators. To create a new email, simply click the icon from the homepage and it takes you straight into the editor. Now, not only do we have a bunch of new beautiful templates, but we can also design from scratch by adding different footers and headers and buttons and icon blocks and things like that. There's also the option to send a test email to yourself like this, and you have integrations. You can import it to MailChimp, you can send it with Gmail, or you can choose to go ahead and download it as HTML to use in your email tool. Now we can build funnels without even leaving Canva. There's so much to it. I have to create a whole new deep dive just about emails to show you the full capabilities. So drop me a comment below if you'd like to see a dedicated tutorial for this or for any other updates that I'm sharing with you today. Okay, this is crazy because what do you mean we can now create mailer boxes in Canva? And you may not know it because it's slightly hidden under the print tab, but you can just search for it and look at that. You have a whole mockup laid out for you so you can just start playing. It's just as easy as designing in Canva, or of course you can get some inspiration from, you guessed it, some templates in here, so you can just add anything you like and then you can print your boxes with Canva. But even if you don't want to, jump into this button in here because it gives you an actual preview with a 3D model and some photos as well. Okay, that alone is a game changer, but Canva didn't stop there. We also have massive updates to the video editor with video 2.0, giving us much more control over how we create. In any video doc type, there's now this new, very sleek timeline with layering, which means that you can now time elements with even more precision like this, or you can even drag and drop anything you like at any point of the video, and you can see that it appears at the top of the playhead. This also means that you don't have to worry about clip boundaries like this. I know a lot of you will also ask about animations and creating amazing videos with the use of match and move. It's definitely still there. You click on the boundary in here and then you can add it like this, but there is a bit of a different workflow to it, which I'm happy to dive into if you want me to create a tutorial on this one. Again, it's one of those that really needs more explanation, so you know what to do if you'd be interested. But that's not all. We also have Magic Video, an AI feature that turns your footage and photos into an edited video instantly, available on the mobile app only. The idea is very similar to what we had with Magic Design for Video, but in my opinion, it's much better. It can can generate with a description, specify the type and style, which already gives you more power over the end result. Plus, you of course get layers because again, we have more control now and you can even get sound effects. So it's really cool. A quick breather, we're only halfway through and Canva is really becoming an all-in-one tool for creators. There's always more to learn. So if you want to go deeper, join the waitlist for my upcoming Canva course. I'll help you master Canva and use it to create content that truly moves your business forward. The next one is super simple, but we've been needing it for a while. Just like we were able to add gradients to our shapes, we can now do the same for text. To do this, just select your text, then go to the color panel, click on the color in here, and then choose the gradient section. From here, have fun because you can really create so many cool effects with this. If you've watched my videos for a while, you'll know how much I love the style brush tool, and I'm excited because it just got a massive upgrade too. You can harmonize graphics with a click or two. Let me show you how. I have this design and it happens so often that you're missing an element or you want to change something, but you can't quite find something with the same vibe. So say I love this one, but I don't drink coffee that much, but I found these different three matcha elements, but you can see that they clash. All you have to do now is to select the coffee, go to the style brush here at the top, click copy art style, and then go over all three and see how good it is. Now I have my custom matcha cup to go with the template. That's next level customization, so just think what this means for your workflow. We're also getting a brand new Grow tab, which is a whole ads ecosystem. Not only can you browse ad inspiration from top brands with filters, you can also share them with your team or remix them to use it as a foundation and then create your own ad from it. You can also create ads with AI based on your website. So the tool will understand your business, any products you may have, or your messaging so that everything can be very clear. Once an ad you create is ready, you can publish it directly to Meta without having to jump and sort it from there. Plus, you'll also get a nice visual summary of your ad account and how the ads perform. Based on that, you'll then also see recommendations. So Grow will highlight your best performing ad. You'll see what's working well and what to improve to get better results. Moving on, the Brand Hub is getting a major upgrade to have more control over what you create and how it represents your brand. The brand kit itself gets a new look, both in the brand tab on the homepage and within the editor. We can now add custom sections and new guidelines with extra options like do's and don'ts, make your own banner for a more on-brand custom feel, and it's still the useful brand kit we all know and love, but there's more to it. The setup is also much easier now because we're getting the option to first set it up with AI through your company website or your own PDF with guidelines. The AI will scan one or the other and then auto-populate the brand kit for you, which saves so much time. And let's also power through the updates in the Canva AI space. Obviously, we've covered some already, but there's so much more. Going back to the brand for just a moment longer, I'm most excited for the brand kit right in the Canva AI. Finally, the stuff we generate can be based on our colors and fonts, so it's much easier to get a good starting point and design quicker this way. I was able to get much better results with it than before, so I'm very impressed. To use this, just go to Canva AI on the homepage, then click the plus sign in here and connect your brand kit. Another useful update we've got here is that we can also pull different assets from Google Drive, Dropbox, and OneDrive. All you need to do then is to describe what you want, and you're then getting the first draft you can take into the editor. And speaking of the editor, Canva AI has now been integrated in here as well, most importantly in the design tab. It's now integrated among other templates at the top, which makes everything feel more smooth because if you can't find a good template, you can try to generate. To do this, just go to the design tab and start typing in the search bar. I'll use this specific prompt. First, Canva will suggest templates to match the vibe, which I love because I always prefer to just draw from real human designs from our amazing Canva creators. And I feel like the search is also very useful now with this AI powered bar. I've been getting good results with it. Then you also have the option to generate design. Again, I'd much rather use real designers, but if you're looking for something specific, this is a useful jumping point. That's not all though. We have something similar in the elements tab with the AI power search bar. But I feel like the new update here with AI elements is quite fun. You can generate photos, videos, codelets, shapes, and forms this way. To do this, again, jump into the Elements tab this time, and in the search box, just put your prompt. From here, you will be able to generate images. You can also generate code and video from here. I'll go to images in this case, and I've got just what I wanted. I can just use it like this and use a background remover and start acting with it as if it was a regular image or a graphic. Let's try to generate a codelet now, just so that I can show you what this update is all about. I've got this prompt, which is specific for a code. I'll hit submit first. Again, it's going to browse through the graphics and the Canva library just to try to find something that matches my prompt. However, you can see that it understands that this is a code prompt rather than looking for an image or maybe a video. So I can just click on it in here and that's going to start coding for me. I can now add this widget to my design like this, and you can see that I can just start interacting with it. So that would be great if it was, of course, a website or something of that sort. So I can just click the start a fresh journey just so that it gives me some affirmations. And of course, when I click the play button, it actually gives me a new one. So this is quite a cool little fun widget that you can add to, again, your websites. And again, the fact that we don't have to go to the Canva AI panel, but we can just generate that inside the editor is really, really great. But notice that you won't be able to refine it further in here. So you can just say regenerate code, good result, bad result, but you cannot kind of edit it further. To generate shapes, all you have to do is to jump under shapes in the new categories. And from here, I'll search for a badger. You can see that I don't see it in here, but I can just click generate shapes. And voila, I have this little badger in here that acts exactly as my other shapes would. Another big AI update, we can generate 3D elements from Magic Media. To do this, go to apps and find Magic Media. Once you click on it, you'll see this brand new 3D tab. And from here, you can just enter your prompt and generate a 3D shape. Then I can just click on it like this. And from here, it's gonna get added to my design. Now, if you hover over it, you'll see this little 3D preview. And when you click and start moving it around, you can see that it just becomes a 3D element that's pretty fun to play with. Sadly, when it exports, it does become flat. Hopefully, we'll get some fun interaction with it later on. However, at the moment, you can play with it in the editor. By the way, we also have a completely new 3D category in the Elements tab with all the different new 3D elements, and you can see that I've just added some fun ones in here, and I can play around with them and just use them as a different elements for my designs as well. Super cool. And while we're at it, with another new Canva update, you can now treat Canva AI as a member of your team to consult. Whenever you're in the editor, you can talk to it through comments or the buttons when you select any elements, just as if you would with a team member. This is great for stuff like suggestions, feedback, and any improvements, and it really saves hours every week. Again, this is a very, very brief demo of just these AI updates. I'm sure you can appreciate this alone could be an hour-long video. So again, drop me a comment if you'd like to see a tutorial, and of course, subscribe because you'll be the first to know when I drop more updates. And something else I'm so, so excited about is the big update to Canva Code. We can now capture data from your coded elements into sheets in real time. This is such a massive update and improvement and makes any widgets or apps that we generate so much more functional. To do this, generate some code and then you'll see this data icon to connect your sheet. You can just create a new one completely and then it's going to start gathering your responses in there in real time. Another update to code gives us the option to edit the widget further when we're already in the editor. All you have to do is to select it, and then you'll be able to jump in and change any of the colors and also any of the fonts as well. This is super cool because when it's embedded on your website, you'll also be able to just select it and then go to the specific data sheet from here. So you don't have to jump back into the Canva AI editor. You can actually just go and inspect it from your website directly. This is just the highlight of these big updates, but I really hope that it's clear that we have so much power to create fun, engaging designs in Canva. We have emails, forms, mailer boxes, data from code, a better brand kit, a new video editor, so many cool AI functions, and that's barely scratching the surface of what you can create using all of those. Drop me a comment comment to let me know which one is your favorite and which ones I should do a detailed tutorial on. Grab the free trial from the description below to try out any pro features for $0. No better time to make use of it. And if you want to see how to actually use Canva AI tools to create content even faster, that's what I covered right here. Make sure to subscribe, like, and hype this video if you can. It makes a massive difference to the channel so that I can deliver more to you. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.